Hi, today I'm going to show you how to convert your source model into PMX model for Mikumiku Dance. You need the VTF edit, PMX editor, Mikumiku Dance, Robot, Blender, and two add-ons including MMD tools and source tools for Blender. You also need to install Python, go to python.org, download it, and install it. I'll link them down in the description so you can get them. First, you have to get your Blender set up first by including those two add-ons into Blender. You open up Blender, you go to Preference, Add-on, tab right here, click on Install. First, you install the Blender source tool, and then you search for the source tool, enable it by clicking over here, and it's done. As for the MMD tools, it's a little bit more tricky. You have to open it and click on MMD tools right here, extract it. Then you have the MMD tool folders, zip it again into a .zip file. Go to Blender again, install from the zip I just made, not the older one, and do that. And now the MMD tool is ready to go. Now we are going to try to get a model, for example, from Steam Workshop. This model is the most popular there, so I just happen to choose it. You copy the link there, Steam Workshop, download there, or any of choices. Direct URL here. The models are your meshes, the bone, UV, weight, all kind of good stuff. The materials are the textures. You open up your crowbar, go to the compile tab, add the MPL input, you choose file and link to your model. It has the .mpl extension. And for the output, you can do work folder or can do subfolder, whatever you want, and to another folder. You can mess around with the configurations, but I have read that you just need to untick the level of depth meshes and bone animation meshes when you decompile. After you're done with decompiling the file, you see a .qc output. Open up Blender, remove the cube, import, soak engine. You find the output from crowbar, which is .qc, then import it. After you import the models, don't click anything yet. Move your mouse to the right corner right here. See the arrow? Click on that. Go down to MMD tab and click Convert Model. Now you have a model for your MMD. You click on Attach Meshes to Model. Click Apply Bone. Click your model again. And then you click Export to save as a .bmx extension. Now you are done with the model. Next, you have to convert all the materials into texture. Open up your VTF edit, go to Tools, Convert folder, find your material folder. The textures are not in the material folders, they are like deep inside there. It's usually the last folder here. I'm just gonna double check it. Yep, all the texture VTF, they're all in the papyrus folder. And now you choose to on any kind of format you choose right here. After you convert everything, you should have all the textures lying around here untidily. Now we're going to open the PMX editor, and then you're going to open your model and find the PMX extension, which was the output from Blender. But now you check the model, you see it has no texture whatsoever. Here's what you want to do next, which is matches the meshes with the texture. You go to material and you see there are some meshes, some parts that don't have any textures. Now I'm going to match the textures with the parts of the body. Go to down the text right here. Click on the teal block and go to file, open textures. Conveniently, most of the time, the part of the body and the texture file have the same name. So we have papyrus head. Just find the papyrus head, which is right here. Click on update, see everything looks just fine. But there's a problem. The color of the texture is not quite good. You can adjust it by click on the material color right here. You have diffuse, specular, ambient. Usually I have the diffuse and the ambient as white and the specular black. After I change the color, it looks pretty normal to me. Now you have to do the same for every part of the body, match the part with the textures. However, we are not done with the model yet. If you're trying to play a motion, it would not work. I'm going to load up a motion file. We'll play something like Specialist from Persona 4. And the model would not move or anything. Therefore, this is the next part we want to do, which is renaming the bones part. Luckily, I wrote a script to make this thing easier. Go to the GitHub link. This is a fork by Nusshouse. He did the most of work. I just added another script on dialog zip. After you download the script, extract it right here. You go to that, then open the folder Python and find the file name translate source bone. this is a Python script, so you need to install Python to run. Before we run the script, we need to save the file first. I'm going to click on File and Save As. I'm going to save it, PA2, because why not? Copy your file right there, paste it in the same folder as the script, just right here. Then you put the name of the file right there. We will output the PA2 source trains.pmx. After you run the script, open the output file. It should be source trains. Now you go to the bone tab and look around. If there are no Japanese name at all, like anywhere, there's still some English name, but they're okay. Or some other weird names, I don't know. But if there are no Japanese name at all, it means my script is incompatible with the model and you have to tediously do all the name scheme, which I will show you later on. Click on Edit, Bone, Merge Bones with similar name, then OK. After you merge all the bones, find a bone with this name, and another bone with this name. Have there be bones to number 3, aka the bone that looks like that. And then you check out your view. The model looks quite big, so you need to like tone it down by go to plugin, system, side change tool, and at the number of 0.3. And your model is all done. Save it as another name, and we're gonna open it in MMD. You wanna save that's something here. It doesn't matter. Now you can open MMD, you can load your model. Click on load right here. Let's save it, this file. Just open that. Now you can try to load a motion. I'm gonna play the classic. And you see, he's in place. He's gonna dance. Gonna do whatever the motion tells him to. There's a problem right here. You see, with the fingers, they're not sticking really right. And if you look at the spine, it's pretty weird as well. The problem is the source model themselves, they don't have the pose like the hand right here. You see that thumb sticking out instead of going straight with all four fingers. You can try to fix it and keep trying that. I don't know. Good luck. I'm going to try with another model called Miku. After output right here, and I am going to open it with the PMX editor. After I open the model, you check on the ball, and you see like they all have the weird name. None of them have the Japanese name, except for the last one, but they don't matter. So this model is an exception to the script, and you have to, like I said 3 minutes ago, tediously do all the work by yourself. I don't think I can show all the work in this video. Probably not a follow-up video, I guess. But yeah.